मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर राहुल आर कुरोती, सेकंड ईयर पीजी रेजिडेंट, विनायक कमिश्नर्स मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड हॉस्पिटल कराईकल. आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग माय पेपर ऑन रोल ऑफ सीटी इन डायग्नोसिंग अपेंडिसाइटिस इन अल्ट्रासाउंड नेगेटिव पेशेंट्स. कमिंग टू इंट्रोडक्शन, अपेंडिसाइटिस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ अब्डोमिनल पेन इन पेशेंट विद एडमिटेड टू इमरजेंसी डिपार्टमेंट. इट कैन बी एसोसिएटेड विद वॉमिटिंग, फीवर एंड डायरिया, बट द मोस्ट कॉमन डिस्ट्रेसिंग सिम्टम इज द पेन. डायग्नोसिंग अपेंडिसाइटिस इन यंग मेल पेशेंट इज मेड आउट इजीली, बट एट द सेम टाइम बिकम्स अ प्रॉब्लम इन द प्रीमेनोपॉजल वुमन हु प्रेजेंट विद सिमिलर क्लिनिकल हिस्ट्री एंड सिम्टम्स. देन फ्यू गायनेकोलॉजिकल सिम्टम्स इन मिडिल एज वुमन कैन ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट विद सिम्टम्स मिमिकिंग अपेंडिसाइटिस. सो इट बिकम्स अ रियल चैलेंज फॉर गेटिंग क्लिनिशियन टू एक्सप्लोर द डायग्नोसिस. टाइमली डायग्नोसिस एंड इंटरवेंशन ऑफ अकूट अपेंडिसाइटिस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ड्यू टू ग्रेव कॉम्प्लिकेशन लाइक परफोरेशन एंड सीटी प्लेस एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन डायग्नोसिंग दिस. इवन इफ there is negative ultrasound finding, and if there is a, even if there is no proper clinical finding, appropriate diagnosis, few surgeons are in favor of early laparotomy to minimize the risk of clinical perforation. Coming to my aims and my main aims and objective is to be is to evaluate the accuracy of CT in identifying appendicitis in ultrasound negative cases and to assess the efficacy of CT in identifying complications of appendicitis, to identify alternative diagnosis of right lower quadrant pain which can mimic appendicitis, and to determine the average CT thickness of normal appendix in new population by measuring the appendix diameter in CT abdomen for other cases. And my sample size being 200, and it's an observational study carried out in department of collaboration department of surgery, Vinayak Medical College and Hospital Karaikal. And these patients were suspected to have shows negative findings in ultrasound. Inclusion criteria: all patients with suspected to have appendicitis who show negative findings in ultrasound. Exclusion criteria: who are medically unfit to undergo contrast studies like a renal failure patient with hypersensitivity reaction and pregnant patient. Methodology: patient who admitted in casualty within the age of 12 to 55 years of age with symptoms of acute renal failure for suffering fever, vomiting, or indigestion within the study. Complete study is a sample of 200 was chosen. Clinical history concerning the present history was taken with the prescribed formula. Informed consent was obtained, was taken from the patient, and also a protocol was approved with by institutional ethical committee. UAG was performed using GE Volvocent Aseptic machine for abdomen and pelvis. And the rank compression color Doppler ultrasound of right lower quadrant pain of the right one, giving attention to localized location of maximum tenderness was performed using employing a linear transducer. And normal appendix was appeared as a blinded end loop with no vermiculation. Greater compression technique is employed to displace intestinal loops, permitting the differentiation between inflamed appendix and compressible intestinal loops. The presence of appendicitis and diagnosis as a tubular blinded structure anterior to the iliac vessels, which is non-compressible with a diameter less than more than greater than 6 mm, and periapical fascinating appendiculary peritoneal fluid are the additional findings. An average time 15 to 20 minutes was taken for each patient. UAG findings was reported as positive or negative for acute appendicitis. Other findings or diagnosis when achieved were also reported. On CT protocol was performed using 32 slide Hitachi Supriya, and our CT abdomen pelvis was taken from sympathetic process of pubic symphysis with ADMN, and contrast material injected was and the overall aspect of elbow in a cubital vein through the 18 gauge canula at a forward of 4 mm regular 40 ms. No overall contrast was used. In reporting format, normal appendix and visualize was also reported, and the CT was report was positive, negative, or inconclusive. And this is a case of a 54 year old male with a history of abdominal pain for 4 days with history of fever and UHC shows lower right lower corner problems. This is appendix about 7 to 8 mm with a periapendicular fascia and which is retrocipital impotent. This is second case, 19 years female, where USG had negative findings. CT shows a diameter greater than 7.5 mm with a periapendicular fascia. This is the third case, 35 years female with abdominal pain. USG negative findings. CT shows a thickened appendix with a diameter more than 11.2 mm with no evidence of wall enhancement or fat standing. This is the fourth case, 13 years male. USG showed a fluid fascia with no peristalsis, no evidence of peristalsis in adjacent bowel. CT shows appendicitis with appendiculate and appendicular lacking right to left fossa. This is 18 years female with the fifth case. USG showed fluid collection with mild dilatation and peristalsis of bowel. CT shows a pneumonia perforation 30 with appendiculate and periapendicular fluid collection noted. Appendix was in pelvic in position. And coming to the statistical analysis, age distribution 20 to 24 years where maximum diagnosed with appendicitis, and males were more affected than females. There was no significant difference in age and sex. Fever was the most common symptom associated with abdominal pain and right quadrant pain, and other positive combination of consumption, useful low back and painful micturition. On ultrasound, 56% people had a normal ultrasound finding, 26 had mesenteric lymphadenitis, 17 had a free fluid. And on CTs, 7.5% patient has a retrocipital appendix as a position, diameter more than less than 6 mm, 56% population can be seen. Whereas 25% patient diameter of surrounded by data. Periapical patient hemolysis is in 38% cases. Appendicitis was proved in this 3.5% cases. Appendicular perforation abscess is in almost 6% of patients. Other findings were repetitive mesenteritis, colitis, colitis, psoas abscess, pancreatitis, uveitis, and ureter ciliary calculus. 27% patients were treated surgically and other respiratory conservative management. Our results after statistical analysis, this brings to a conclusion that out of 200 patients, 77 patients were found to have appendicitis based on CT with a negative ultrasound finding. Based on this study, patient with a CE findings of an appendicular diameter more than 6 mm found to have appendicitis, which was found in accordance with other correlative findings, histological correlation and intra findings. This brings to a conclusion that CT is more accurate in diagnosing appendicitis in patient with negative ultrasound finding with a significant sensitivity, specificity, and positive and negative value. Coming to conclusion, the result of the study among the patient with a low vomiting fever, low back ache, and with equivocal negative ultrasound findings, CT plays an important role. Imaging estimated imaging modality of size. 77 cases were found to have appendicitis in CT among the study population of 200, among which 50% of patients, that is 25% of cases, have a diameter of 7 to 8 mm with a periapendicular fat standing appendicular wall, the wall has been and diagnosed as appendicitis due to retrocecal appendiculation of the appendix, which are substituted by gas shadows and obesity. And obesity might have led to non vascular, thus giving USG a negative picture for diagnosing appendicitis. CT is the best imaging modality of size, which is substituted by gas and obesity, other mimics of appendicitis were mesenteric lymphadenitis, right distributed calculus, ileocecal thickening, colitis, which were also made in CT images. Normal appendix diameter in patient with right lower quadrant pain and diagnosis condition other than appendicitis, mesenteric lymphadenitis, ileocecal thickening were as a 5.7 mm in CT. Thus coming to a conclusion, so that CT being a prime modality of size in aiding clinicians and diagnose appendicitis in patient with ultrasound finding, the true correlation of appendicular diameter, periapendicular fat standing, and wall enhancement. These are my references. Thank you.